Hey guys, it's Bailey. Welcome back to the channel and thanks so much for tuning in to a video that is going to be all about what's new from e.l.f. Well, new-ish. I've had these products for, they're a combination of things that I've purchased and things that e.l.f. has sent me, and I've had them for some of them as long as a month, maybe a month and a half, so they're new-ish. They're not quite at the top of the what's new page from e.l.f., but they're still relatively new. So I wanted to not only share my thoughts on those things, but also give you swatches and then even demos of some of the products. So let's go ahead and dive in. First, starting off with what is kind of a fail. I saw that they launched some new eyeshadow sticks, which I'm a huge fan of shadow sticks. They're great. More often than not, they're great one and done things. You swipe on your lid. Sometimes, depending on the formula, you don't even have to set them. You just swipe, blend, you're good to go. I love them for a quick and easy look. So I picked up two shades. One is rose gold and one is metallic mocha. They look gorgeous. The shades themselves are beautiful. However, I haven't had a ton of luck with e.l.f. eye crayons. Their smudge pots, amazing. I wish they hadn't scaled back their shade range, because that is like the best $2 you may ever spend on makeup with those smudge pots. They're so amazing. How I just haven't had the same luck with their crayons, and the same is true for these. You know, they say they're no bud shadow sticks, but that is totally not the case. Worn alone, you definitely have to set these with something. Otherwise, they're going to move around and it's going to be like Crease City across your eyelids. So be sure and prime, and then you even have to set it on top of that. And for me, it just defeats the purpose and convenience of an eyeshadow stick, especially when there are so many others out there. I have a whole video on shadow sticks if you want to check it out. I'll link it up here. But there are just so many out there that you don't have to go through all the effort with, and they truly are like the best on-the-go products ever. So these were a miss for me. Next, let's talk about the products in their collaboration with Christian Siriano. He's been collabing all over the place. He also did a collaboration with Kiss Impress Nails, which are my favorite. I have a whole video trying those nails on too, because he nailed it. So I have really high hopes for this. e.l.f. sent me all, what is this, four pieces in the collection, including this bag. There is an eyeshadow palette, a lip gloss, and a liquid lipstick. So let's go ahead and run through everything. The bag, pretty basic. I mean, I feel like I have a ton of makeup bags, so it's not something that I would necessarily go after. It's a decent size. You can throw it in a, you know, medium to large purse, kind of fit everything, especially specifically products from this collection, but it's okay. As you can see, everything in this collection has this hot pink metallic look to it, which I'm pretty in love with. Plus this, is it a leopard? I can't tell what pattern it is. It kind of looks like a leopard situation going on here. Again, big fan of that too. So let's start first with the palette. This is a magnetized palette, which I really like. And I realized I don't think e.l.f. has done this, or else they don't do it frequently, especially compared to some of the other products or palettes that I talk about in this video. I really appreciate this is a metallic palette, or metallic, magnetic palette, and it has a firm grasp so that you can tell it's gonna stay closed, but it's just so much easier to open than a lot of their other palettes. Not a huge deal, just something I noticed. There's a nice big mirror you get in here, and then you get six, technically seven shadow shades, I suppose, but this one over here is a nice big shade, so you can use it as a highlight, obviously, on your eyes, or today I have it worn as a highlight all over my face. It is gorgeous. And that, oh, and you also get this dual-ended brush. One is like this blending, this fluffy crease brush, and then you have a more flat but still dense shadow brush to kind of pat and pat color on across the lid. Actually a pretty decent brush given the size. It feels a little flimsy, but it's pretty functional, especially in the way of giving you both a crease and flat shadow brush, so that's really nice too. Back to the shadows themselves, this is quite the colorful palette. You get that highlight shade, like I said, that big one over there, and then on the other side, going lightest to deepest or most colorful, you have a somewhat matte cream or eggshell shade up here, and then below that a shimmery light champagne shade. Then there is a bluey aqua, a gorgeous light mossy green, a matte purple, and then a deep black and plum up here in the corner, which in the pan looks shimmery. It looks like it has a slightly blue shift to it, but I have to say, actually applying it, it takes a lot of layering up for you to actually see that sort of shift. I think for all practical purposes, it applies like a matte shadow, so I would treat it like a matte shadow. All in, you get a good selection of textures, a good blend of mattes and shimmers, and obviously a good blend of colors as well. You have some staple light neutral shades. I do wish, in terms of an isolated kind of one-off palette goes, that they would have given you a nice crease shade. I know those are a dime a dozen. They come in every other palette. You could have them as a single, but just in terms of being able to take one palette on the go, I wish they would have just put like a mid-tone brown crease shade, or maybe, you know, two, one deeper, lighter. You can mix and match the two to make your perfect crease shade. But either way, that's what I feel like this palette's lacking. However, the quality is amazing, whether it's the shimmer or the matte shades. They're just so finely milled. They're very, very smooth, very pigmented, especially for those colorful shades. And I'm just overall really impressed with the quality here. So if you're thinking of picking this up, and obviously if the colors kind of strike your fancy, because not everyone is a bold turquoise or bright green wearer, but if they do, I'd recommend you check it out. Now onto the lips. There is a matte liquid lipstick. This is in the shade Fuchsia, appropriately. It is the signature kind of fuchsia color of the collection. This is a really light, airy liquid lipstick formula. It applies like a mousse, but a very thin, doesn't feel thick or cakey, but it is very drying. It's pretty transfer proof once it dries down, but as a result, it's really not forgiving on the lips in terms of hydrating, moisturizing. Just, it's comfortable because it's so light, but over time, the dryness starts to wear on the lips, I think. Still, it's a really nice light formula if that's what you're after in a lipstick. It's long wearing, and the color is so pigmented and gorgeous. Despite being ultra pigmented, sometimes what I find I can run into with liquid lipsticks is the pigments there, but it applies so streaky, like it's just not consistent. And this is pretty perfect when you apply it. It takes one coat, it's fully opaque, there are no streaks. It's pretty fantastic. The gloss is not, it's just okay. It has this light, actually, what is the shade? It's called pink. It's just called pink, but it's actually more of a soft baby pink in here. Has kind of a milky finish, if that's even the right word, which definitely shears out across the lips. Like, it definitely doesn't look kind of gross milky on the lips, if that makes sense. It shears out, but as a result, kind of just becomes like a pale pink kind of nothing gloss. I find I have to re-dip the doe foot in here multiple times to get like a good glossy coat on my lips. It just takes a lot of layering up. Even once it's layered up, I don't notice it giving my lips this huge high shine effect. And then once you do build up and get to see that pigment and that shine, I do notice that the creamy consistency can kind of run in your fine lines as it bleeds throughout the day. Not immediately, but it's just one of those where the finish can sometimes separate and move on your lips throughout wear. So it's just not for me. All right, it is like palette palooza. I have three more new palettes from e.l.f. to talk about. First, let's talk about what's on my eyes. This is another Mad for Matte eyeshadow palette, but this one is called Jewel Pop. I mean, pretty appropriately named because it is nothing but bright jewel tones in here, which I love. I'm wearing a couple of the purple shades on my lid today. They did include kind of a mid-tone. This is actually more of like a borderline mustard, I would say, brown, but it still complements the other shades in here nicely. If you want to blend this with what is kind of a deeper taupe here in your crease, if you want to do a nice crease shade, which I feel you kind of have to have with all these brights, you don't have to have it, but I personally find it's super helpful to have that with bright shades to help kind of ground the look. So you got that in here, and you just have some pretty beautiful shades. Now, I will say, while they are very soft, they definitely swatch very pigmented, and they can be built on the lid. You absolutely have to wear a primer in order to get totally even coverage on your lid. These aren't shadows that you can kind of forget to wear a primer or have a primer built into them. You have to wear one, otherwise I think you'll be able to see in the tutorial today where I didn't apply primer, it takes quite a bit of layering, and even as I look at my eyes now, they are kind of separating and just kind of wearing inconsistently across the lid. That goes with so many different shadows, which is why I'm not really faulting this palette for it. It's just there are some out there where I don't need to wear a primer and they wear beautifully across the lid. These, just to ensure best application and wear, definitely be sure to wear a primer, because once you do, these colors are popping. I mean, what an affordable way to get some seriously bright shadows that apply beautifully, blend super easily in with each other, and truly come off as pigmented as they look in the pans. Like, this is just, I think this is a really nice palette. And on to the last two palettes. These are also winners, spoiler alert, but they are part of the Chromatic Eyeshadow Palette Collection. There's only two of them. I have both of them, but they're just newly launched types of palettes e.l.f. The first of which is called Posh Peacock, and it is a collection of greens. You see, you get what, 3, 6, 7 shades in one palette, plus a nice size mirror and another dual-sided brush. Again, kind of feels flimsy, but is still totally functional with both a fluffy blending, like crease brush, and a flat shader brush down here on the end. Both of these palettes consist of a mixture of textures. You have some mattes, you have some shimmers, some iridescence, even like in this Posh Peacock. This this gorgeous kind of minty teal over here is more like this iridescent, not duochrome, but just it wears more of an iridescent, so you can wear it lightly across the lid, or if you pack it on over a deeper or more colorful base, like this deep green over here, it really shifts the look, which I love. So that is the Posh Peacock palette. Great for greens if you are a green lover or a turquoise or teal lover. The other palette they have is the Bird of Paradise palette, which I think might not be the right name for this, because I thought Bird of Paradise were almost like the Mad for Matte Jewel Tone palette, like vibrant and all sorts of different colors, but that's neither here nor there. This is really more of a neutral mauve tone palette, so this might be more of a comfort zone for a wider range of people, just because it is those kind of comfortable browny, mauve, pinky berry sort of tones, not getting too bold, too bright, just safe but still beautiful. So again, here you have a mix of textures. You have this gorgeous iridescent gold, your mid-tone browns, your deep berry lilac-y purples, and they all just blend and mix beautifully together. Really, I just have nothing bad to say about these palettes. They're good, the quality is good, they have a nice mix of textures, a wide shade range. It really just comes down to kind of which one appeals to you, but they really are just nice palettes in terms of performance. The packaging is a little bulky. I feel like they could have slimmed it down a little bit, maybe to something like one of the Mad for Matte palettes, or even like the Christian Siriano palette, but not a major complaint. You still get that nice big mirror. That is it for me, guys. Those are all the new things I've tried recently from e.l.f. I know they are cranking out new stuff these days. It's like something new on the website every single day, but that's what I have tried from them recently. I'd love to hear if you guys are interested in trying these. If you've tried some of the even more recent products from e.l.f., let us know if those are hits or misses down in the comments below. Besides that, guys, thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and I will catch you in the next video. Bye, guys.